Hi friends, today I would like to welcome Jay Krishna Rawazi on My Cricket Story, powered by Cricket Dost. Hey Dost, let's play with Cricket Dost. Krishna Rawazi, welcome to the show.
Hi Abhinay, thank you.
Okay, Rawazi, you have been working with cricket since 21 years of a great journey. So I would like to start questioning about your childhood, how you entered into cricket, and how was your experience in college time when you were reading in Andhra Pradesh during your BCom?
So actually my childhood entirely went in Visakhapatnam. Okay. We used to play in that on the hills. It's a city is located with the beautiful hills surrounding. So yeah, we used to play in the hills down, you know. So okay, my childhood went very well. I got into the cricket in 1994. Okay. So first I was joined in one club which is called Sports 11.
Okay.
My journey started from club cricket. So then I not played the highest level cricket, but I represented the district and schools.
Please. It's all about playing cricket just like a player, but you know, whenever you are taking such type of responsibility to be a coach in a team, and that's a huge responsibility is coming to your shoulder. So what are the main basic qualities that a coach should have like you, and what are the challenges that you were facing whenever you were coaching the team as well?
See, is again, it's depending on the which team you are handling. Yeah. You're handling under 13, you're handling 19 team, or you're handling first class team.
Yeah.
So each team has its own challenges.
Yes, sir.
So when you're handling in the higher level, you should provide a very good environment. Let first class cricketers execute their skill in the middle with the no fear. That environment you should provide in the dressing room.
Yes, sir.
So that is a challenge in higher level cricket. So that is the, you need a very good quality of man management in the higher level. Whereas when you're handling in the beginners, so you create a fun environment. Let the kids should come, have a nice fun. They should learn the game and make the friends. So each area is demands different challenges.
Yes. But when we consider the growing age, like under 16, under 19 cricket teams, they have also so many questions that would be arising in their minds, and they are very challenging also. And to tackle a under 19 young guy, I think it's very difficult to just read his or her mentality. So how you manage such type of challenging task to handle from their inner side, from their the inner essence that is coming from their side? Because, you know, there are so many disturbing elements that would be just reflecting in their personality. So how you manage such teenagers especially?
See, again, it's a depending on each individual. So if you ask 19 boys, yes, definitely it's a very growing age and they got, you know, a lot of attraction, everything. So we coaches, we should give the task and we should provide values, you know, in that age, especially it's called amateur cricket. You need to inculcate values into the system. Okay. That when you're building your cricket career on values, that values will guide in critical moments, you know, in your, when you're facing in your life, you want to take decisions, right time, right decisions, the values will give path. So you need a, when you're building your cricketing career, you should build on your values. Then the values will take care in your rest of life.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know, especially when the team is winning, that means the motivation is in the higher level. Self-motivation will be there. But when the team is going down years with performances, and when they are losing continuously, so how you manage first type of situations?
So first of all, we should understand, Vinay, winning and losing is a byproduct.
Yes.
It's end product it is. Okay. So one day you're going to win, one day you're going to lose.
Yes, yes.
The most important thing is whether your team is giving you effort or not. Whether you're giving as per your potential when you're getting the middle, whether you're delivering goods or not. That is the key. So effort is a key. Rest is this a process. When you're focusing on the process, the result will come automatically.
Yes, sir.
If you start focusing on the winning, then automatically you're creating high pressure in your dressing room, in your team environment. Okay. Yes, so best thing is small things go per focus karo, systematically karo, then the result will come automatically. It will fall automatically.
Yes, sir. Sir, you are also one of the most specialized bowling coach, and as per your bio data, I came to know. Sir, nowadays, most of the players from gully cricket, everyone just focus on the batsman. Focus on the batsman, how he's just hitting the ball and he's sending just beyond the boundaries. But whenever we see such crucial matches like Bumrah, what he did in his last match between Australia and India, what he played. So it's being a very crucial moment when a bowler is taking a wicket in a crucial situation. So what would you like to say about the bowlers and the aspirants and the gully cricketers who are doing bowling nowadays? And what would be the tips from your side, sir?
See, the most of the bowlers came from gully cricket only. Even the cricketers also. No cricketer come from academy. Okay. Yeah. So the match environment will provide cricketers, future cricketers. Okay.
Yes.
So definitely gully cricket ma kya hota, there is a lot of competition.
Yeah.
A lot of tactical things.
Tactical.
They will learn. Okay.
Yeah.
Because they give high importance to the winning. For that, they will give maximum effort. So the gully cricket create that game awareness and competitiveness. Okay. So udhar se aane ke baad, then those are coming from the gully cricket.
Okay.
And those are, see, the very simple in my childhood days, I had a myth that I think that no Indian can bowl 140, especially in the 19th era.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you look at after 2000, Ajit Agarkar started bowling 140. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If you look at right now,
yes, sir.
Right now, everyone is bowling almost 140 plus in Indian bowling attack. If you look at, if you ask me, our bowling attack is the best bowling attack present in the world. So there is, you know, for the fast bowlers, you need a very good work ethics, okay, and you need a very good training background, and the highest level you need to have a good mindset and a very good professional behaviors that will help you to excel in higher level. So technical tips I don't give because I will definitely those are want to play, those are want to excel in the higher level, they need mindset and professional behavior. These are two key things. If they inculcate in the day-to-day life, then definitely they will excel in the higher level.
Okay, sir. Sir, COVID-19 has affected a lot to the gully crickets and to the village level crickets. Because, you know, there are so many bans that government has done and nobody is coming outside the ground. So, what should they do to just have a flow from their side? A player, what should he do now?
When I first couple of months, definitely it's affected for the gully cricket.
Yes, sir.
Right now, gully cricket is going
on.
Still, I'm giving you the interview. I can make out from my window. There is playing on match outside. Okay.
Yes.
So right now, gully cricket, no. As especially the BCCI and the club cricket.
Yes, sir.
Association cricket, yes, affected.
Yeah.
Might it will start from January onwards, maybe February onwards, once vaccine is come up. Definitely we'll going to listen very good, positive word.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
But Delhi cricket, yes, they're playing cricket right now. They're enjoying because there is no rules for the Delhi cricket.
Yes, sir.
That is advantage.
Yeah.
Because the rules are made by players.
Sir, that is the best part of a gully cricket, that if you are the owner of the bat, that means you are going to open the game
Absolutely.
like that. And yeah, sir. And so many times, you know, you refused that I have not got run out. This was very close. So you can also just cancel the dismissing things at that time. Sir, how important it is to be self-motivated, and how it is important to release the stress that's coming initially whenever you were going to the cricket. The stress is coming, the most crucial matches, that is giving more stress to the player. So how important is it for the stress management in cricket?
See, again, it is depending on the age group. In India, we used to play this game for fun, you know. Once we get into the professional shoe, once we wear the professional shoe, then definitely it will create a lot of pressure. Okay.
Yes.
So first of all, you should understand why is the pressure is coming. When your expectations comes up, once goes up,
yes.
So definitely it's start creating the pressure. So once you stay in the present, if you're able to keep yourself in the stay in the present, then there is no pressure. But you need to practice. Main bolne ke liye bahut simple hai. It's a very simple to tell. You keep yourself in present, but you need to lot of practice.
Yes.
Then you can overcome your pressure.
Yes.
आप पूछ सकते हैं कृष्णा सर आपको ये principle पता है? Then आपको pressure नहीं है. मैं बोलूँगा मेरे को भी pressure है. Everybody has his pressure, but you need to overcome this pressure. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So her individual has pressure, but they will overcome.
Yes, sir.
By staying in present, yes, you will get a lot of thoughts in your mind. Always, if you look at either you stay in the past or you stay in future. Most of the time, we stay in both. We very difficult to stay in present, but you need to practice.
Sir.
Once you stay in present, you can overcome present.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, Cricdost is a company who is promoting the gully cricketers. It is known as Street Stars Finder.
Okay.
Whenever you are playing in the gullies, whenever you are playing in the small villages, we are broadcasting that matches and we are giving them a platform to the next, go to the next level, to improve in the next level.
Super.
So that everyone can see their matches, everyone can observe their skills, observe their techniques. So what would you like to say about the digital things that is going on nowadays? There are different companies, the different types of platforms are there to learn, actually, because you know, before 2000 it was not possible to just observe different cricketers digitally. So now this platform has gone on in an improving rate. So what would you like to say about digital things that is connected with cricket now?
See, earlier we used to read the books, used to read articles.
Yes, sir.
To know about the
skills,
legend cricketers. Okay, it's very difficult to watch live matches, you know. So we used to hear a radio commentary.
Yeah.
Then after 85, now slowly television is introduced. The couple of matches we were can able to view the live, you know, in TV. Then after, especially present, the net, the digital world is explore like anything. So it is a very helpful to modern generation to know about the place, game, you know, the data, everything. You know, it's a how you going to use this tool, use this this modern you know, the technology. So how you going to use and how you going to take this one is depending on you.
Yes, sir.
So once the technology is reaching high, yes, some minus also is there. But how you going to use mobile? Yes, it's a now the entirely world on your hand. Okay, it's a gives a lot of information. Okay, but again, it's killing your valuable time also. So then, how you manage? I will say definitely you have to update, otherwise you can't survive in this world.
Yes.
So definitely digital is a very, very important. Whatever the modern technology comes, you need to understand and you need to how to use. That is a very, very important as a modern society.
Yes, sir. Sir, nowadays tennis cricket is going on so popular like anything. You can see in different gullies, in different places, because deuce cricket is not suitable for each and every pitches, each and every area that you need to play. So what is the futures that you can see in tennis cricket also?
See, if you ask any cricketer, those are play 100 test matches or 200 or 300 one day matches. Yes. If you ask them how they were started their journey, they will, everybody say that we started with the tennis ball only. Yes. We played in Delhi. You know, if you ask Sunil Gavaskar, you ask Sachin Tendulkar or Sehwag, or you can ask Dhoni. Yes. They will tell, yaar, main bachpan mein, maine galli mein khelta tha. Kaise khelta tha? Tennis ball se khelta tha. So that is how actually journey. So we don't say that the tennis ball ka cricket nahi hai. Still, lot of tournaments hota hai, Pongal mein tournaments hota hai. So you need every type of, see, L. Balaji come from same background. He yes. played tennis ball cricket and straight away represented Tamil Nadu. The similar way, the Siraj, fast bowler, he plays for the tennis ball cricket only in Hyderabad. So like that, every cricketer, if you look at the background, those are play higher level cricket. Sabhi yes. galli se aaya.
Yes, sir.
So lot of great future for tennis ball cricket.
Yeah. Krishna Rao ji, last but not the least, I would like to give some suggestions that you would give, like to give to the players, to the aspirants, to those who are playing in the village, those who are playing in the downyard area, those who are playing in the hills areas, like you also. So what would you like to say about the aspirants?
See, play cricket. This will teach you life lessons. Okay. Lot of life lessons sikhata hai. Ye game, this yeah. game teaches you how to face challenges. Okay. So play game, enjoy. Okay.
And that means it's connected to our life also.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it gives a lot of, it's teach you a lot of life lessons, life values. So play this game and enjoy.
Yeah, sir. Okay, thank you very much, Krishna Rao ji, for sharing your experiences, sharing your ideas and values with us in Cricket My Story, My Cricket Story, powered by Cricket Dost. Hey Dost, let's play with Cricket Dost. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Vinay. Thank you. Namaskar.